have a great Outlook video for you today. A lot of people use Outlook. A lot of people are on the Outlook desktop. I actually work with Outlook desktop and Outlook on the web pulled up every day. I love Outlook on the web. So this video is going to cover three reasons to use Outlook on the web, and I'm focusing on just the calendar. So let's dive in right now. I have Microsoft Edge running. I pulled up Outlook.com, signed into my account. Edge works, Chrome works, whatever browser, I don't care. To get to your calendar over on the far left, for me, it's this second icon that says calendar. And I happen to be in week view for April 30th through May 6th. You can change your view. Reason number one to use Outlook on the web for calendar. I'm sitting here and I've got appointments and I have meetings and I even have some categories running right here. So I just want to see appointments. An appointment is something for you and no one else. No one else got invited. So I can go to filter. It says all. I want to look at appointments. Watch it change. Those are appointments. That is just stuff for me to do. No one else is invited. I'm going to go back to all. Now I'm going to go the other way. I want to go and look at meetings. Other people have been invited or someone has invited me. So they have this one really cool. Go to meetings. All meetings. No, I want to see meetings that I'm the organizer. For me, these are Microsoft Teams meetings. Remember in Microsoft Teams, you got three roles: organizer, presenter, and attendee. If you schedule the Teams meeting, you're the organizer. So I'm going to say, I'm the organizer. Those are the meetings where I'm the organizer. Let's go the other way. And I like that it says what you're filtering by right here. I want to see meetings where I'm an attendee. I know that Carol has invited me to two meetings where she's the organizer. Maybe more, by the way. Nope, there they are. If you mouse over them, by the way, it'll give you the date and time. If I go back to I'm the organizer, there you go. That's who I invited. Another cool feature. So here we go. One more with the filtering here. I am going to go back to all. If you notice, I like to use categories in case you're wondering what in the world is a category. I need a prep for this Excel Power Query class. I'm going to right click. Categorize. You can rename these. So notice it says green, orange, purple. You would come down here to manage and rename them. I'm going to make that one purple. So anything in purple for me is when I need to be prepping for a class. So here we go. Filter, categories. I want to see purple. There you go. That would be all the time frames where I needed to prep. Let's just do one more real quick, because if you notice, I had some stuff in orange. So let's go to the orange category, and there are those two right here. Apparently, I'm working on a new outline for Excel and a new outline for Teams training. And there are other ones in here, but we've covered filtering. That is item number one. Item number two, why you should be using the Outlook on the web calendar. It is so much easier to schedule a meeting with Outlook on the web than Outlook desktop. I know I've covered this before, but it's definitely worth showing. I'm going to come over here to new event. I want to do an event. I am making this up. Budget meeting. Who do I want to invite? I want to invite Christian. The minute I type in Christian's name, it immediately starts showing me times that he is available and I'm available. I'm going to also add Carol Wilson. Continuing on right here, look in the bottom right corner. There's me, there's Christian, there's Carol. I can just pick a time here. I've also got some preferences here. You want to make this ever how many minutes you want to. And I think I want to do it. It already is set for next week. So there you go. You can easily change this. I want to pick this time right here. Just click it. So I don't have to go searching for times. Also, if you were to change the length of this meeting, it would be updating these. So it's just a great feature. And then to send this off is right here. But before you send it off, do you want this to be a Teams meeting? Sure. I love Teams. Hit send. Event created. There you go. So that is how I usually schedule my meetings. It beats Outlook Desktop. Item number three, why I like to come in here, is I will occasionally use this cool board feature. When you come to board, click on default, or you can make a new one. I'm gonna just go to default. The board is a great way to add stuff and not just see your calendar, but you can come over here and add tasks, you can add files, you can make notes. And if you're saying, well, how do you add stuff? It is right here, add to board. You pick what you want from in here. You can even add weather, clock, and all that. You can move the board around. You can change dates. Real simple. You can resize stuff. So it is a board for you to work on and organize it any way you want to. I will frequently use this when I'm in meetings also. So in case you're wondering, Outlook on the web has so many cool features in it that the desktop version doesn't have, that I'm going to actually pull up Outlook Desktop. This is going to be real quick. I have Outlook Desktop running, and you're going to say, Chris, that is not the Outlook Desktop. This is going to be the new Outlook Desktop. I am running a preview of it right here. I've already turned it on. Notice the new Outlook Desktop is going to look very similar to Outlook on the web, including all the cool features that I just mentioned. We can come in here and do our filtering. We got the option to automatically schedule a new event and it pop in and populate who's coming. In the inbox, you can flag messages, pin messages, snooze messages. A lot of great features are coming to Outlook Desktop. So another reason to subscribe to my channel. So there are your three reasons. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe. Enjoy the rest of your day. I appreciate your time. Thank you.